Here in West Palm Beach, Florida, there are beautiful, quaint, historic homes and neighborhoods all around. But between the late 80s and early 90s, almost 1,000 historic homes disappeared. I'm Taylor, and you might not know that my fantasy book series, Kingdom of Florida, begins its story in 1989 in a quiet neighborhood in West Palm Beach, Florida. The main characters, a group of children, live on a street much like this one, which sits next to attractive land that once housed about 350 homes. In fact, I may or may not have imagined the characters living on this very street. Just a block south of here is where the former Hillcrest neighborhood once stood. In the late 80s, newspaper articles described Hillcrest as a place that would seem to have everything a community would want. Schools, a park, streets lined with lush trees, little crime, and some exquisite old homes. But in 1987, the fate of the peaceful neighborhood was up in the air. The Hillcrest neighborhood faced two major hurdles on its western border. First, the widening of Interstate 95. Second, the growth of Palm Beach International Airport just beyond it. As the streets of Hillcrest rested in the flight path of the airport, residents had seen a huge increase in air traffic and noise. With this in mind, along with a need to increase the airport's footprint, county officials used funds provided by the Federal Aviation Administration to begin a massive voluntary buyout of the homes closest to the path. But what began as a voluntary measure soon became more necessary to the homeowners that remained, for Hillcrest slowly transformed into a sort of ghost town, inviting robbery, vandalism, decay, and a general eerie feeling as the homes that were bought out there were then demolished, leaving empty gaps between the remaining houses. One glimmer of light came in the form of a government grant of $6 million that allowed for the city to sell or give away historic homes in the Hillcrest neighborhood to anyone who was willing to move them. They could give the homes away for free to anyone who wanted one. All the new owners would be responsible for were the costs of moving and to have possession of a plot of land on which to move the house. Though there were funds to cover up to 58 historic homes, only a handful of them were moved before the wrecking balls swung through Hillcrest. Estimates at the time put the cost of moving a house between $27,000 and $65,000, nearly the cost of some homes back then. From a thorough scouring of countless newspaper articles and other historical and official documents, I was able to account for at least six Hillcrest homes that were moved and are still standing to this day in other parts of the city. Whenever I drive by these homes, I smile and wonder at all of the history contained in those nearly 100-year-old walls. After just a few years of the county demolishing homes, though, there were only 10 left. Some stragglers held on for several more years. Three families maintained control of their homes up to 1999, when the county used a legal power called eminent domain to force the sales of all three properties. Eminent domain is the right of a government to take private property for public use, with payment or compensation. It primarily exists to allow a government to purchase property for something in the public interest, like clearing land for a school or other social good. However, eminent domain is often used in ways that aren't always in the public interest. For example, in the Hillcrest situation, the last remaining residents decried the fact that the government had no concrete plans for developing the now vacant land, even though they'd been forced out of it. But let's get back to the 80s. Elsewhere in West Palm Beach during the same period, the late 1980s, city officials initiated a plan to raise about 600 abandoned and crime-ridden homes throughout the city. Many in the center of the downtown area in a project known then as the Downtown Uptown Development, but later realized a couple decades later as City Place, and eventually renamed Rosemary Square. This demolition project was immense. According to the developers at the time, only a handful of properties were occupied, but eyewitness sources, friends who grew up in the area, say that wasn't necessarily true. Many of these rundown homes were used as crack houses, and it's likely that many of them were occupied by squatters that weren't on the books. Either way, the city said goodbye to another huge swath of unique and historic homes. The quick destruction of hundreds of historic homes led some in the city to fight for historic preservation laws, and in November of 1990, the first historic preservation ordinance was adopted. Unfortunately, the damage had been done. West Palm Beach lost a treasure trove of unique homes, some even designed by notable architects like Addison Meisner and Maurice Fatio. Newspaper articles from the time state that every historic property was to have photos taken and sketches drawn to preserve the architectural details. And if you have any more information about that, let me know in the comments. So, what happened to the Hillcrest property after all of the homes were gone? With jets flying overhead on the regular, options were pretty limited. There were early attempts to turn the plot into a golf course, with Donald Trump even offering to buy it in the year 2000. That fell through. In late 2005, Palm Beach Atlantic University made a pitch at the property with hopes to build an athletic campus to complement their main hub downtown. That deal went through. Today, nearly two decades later, the athletic campus is flourishing as an integral part of the university. Today, West Palm Beach boasts 17 historic districts and at least 45 individually designated historic sites, each with its own character and its own story. Like Flamingo Park, which plays a special role in the Kingdom of Florida book series. Though neighborhoods change and houses come and go, some of their stories continue and live on to this very day. I'm Taylor Thomas Smythe, author, designer, and creator, and this has been Kingdom of Florida Beyond the Legend. Make sure you're subscribed so you don't miss the next exciting episode coming to you soon, and check out The Golden Alligator, the first book in the Kingdom of Florida series, to find out how the historic Flamingo Park neighborhood ties into this exciting adventure. Thanks for watching!